على محمد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم بالعالمين إنك حميد مجيد. سبحانك اللهم لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين وما توفيقي إلا بالله عليه توكلت. أما التوكل فأن تبشر أسباب مع شهودك المدبر. أي علمي أن ما يشاء يقع ولا يكون غير ما شاء صنع وباعتماد القلب في دفع البلاء أصلا ورفعه إلى ما نزل على المصور وفي إيصال نفع وحظه من الزوال بعد وصوله إليك تصل إلى مقام فطنا توكل يا رب. هذا باب التوكل جعلنا الله وإياكم من أهل التوكل. هذا باب التوكل، ما هو حد التوكل؟
بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the chapter of tawakkul, of reliance upon Allah, and may Allah make us all from those who rely upon Him. What does tawakkul mean? What does this reliance?
لو توكلتم على الله حق توكله لرزقكم كما ترزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. لو توكلتم على الله
if you were to rely upon Allah as fittingly he is relied upon, then he would bless you and provide for you. He would provide for you as he provides for the birds that they leave in the morning with empty stomachs and they return with full stomachs.
لا تفكر عن شيء.
That you would not have to worry about a thing.
لا تفكر عن غد.
You would not worry about tomorrow.
يقول الإمام الشافعي إذا أصبحت عندي قوت يوم فخلي اللوم عني يا سعيد ولا تخطر هموم غد ببالي فإن غدا له رزق جديد. يقول الإمام الشافعي
Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah said
that
if I was to start my day and I have my provision for just today, then don't blame me. Don't ask me about tomorrow. Don't bother me about tomorrow.
لا تخطر هموم غد ببالي. لا تحدث.
Don't ask me about tomorrow.
لا تخطر هموم غد ببالي.
Don't even enter the thoughts of tomorrow into my mind. They're not there.
إن غدا له رزق جديد.
Tomorrow there's a new sustenance.
إذا وصلنا عليه له رزق جديد وإذا متنا فذلك رزق آخر.
That if we reach tomorrow, yes, there's that sustenance. That's if we reach it, and if we die before that, then there's a different sustenance in the grave.
إذا أصبحت عندي قوت يوم فخلي اللوم عني يا سعيد ولا تخطر هموم غد ببالي فإن غدا له رزق جديد.
That Imam al-Shafi'i said that
اسمعوا كلام العارفين.
Listen to the statements of the knowers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said that if I get up in the morning and I have my provision that I need for today, then O Sa'id, do not blame me after that. He said, don't even enter the thoughts of tomorrow. Don't talk to me or ask me about what about tomorrow, because tomorrow has its own sustenance. One day I was sitting by our Shaykh Murabit al-Hajj. May Allah have mercy on him and benefit us from the blessings of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and of their blessings.
ومن تسببه وتوكله واعتماده على النفع بالصدقات سمعت شيئا عجيبا.
That from his
توكل واعتماده أن التوكل الأول هو الإعطاء.
From his reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his reliance upon Allah's guarantee that one of the means, the first means of receiving sustenance is to give.
فكان هناك شخص طاع طمع فيه شاءه كالعادة الناس تطمع فيه من شتى البلاد ويعطيها ما عنده.
That a man came to him who wanted something from him, and this was normal as usual. People from all over would come, hoping he'd give them something, and he would always give them whatever he had. So he told one of the students, "Give him what we have. Give him whatever is there." So then the student was telling Murabit al-Hajj, he said, please just leave something behind, leave something, don't give him just everything.
لا يمنعه عطاء اليوم دون غد. خلاص دعه قال أعطيه ما هو موجود خلاص غدا إن شاء الله سيكون.
That it was he mentioned to him the poetry that a person had written in praise of someone else. He said, how generous is that individual? How generous is he?
ملفورات في ماء في عطائه للماء كمثله وما.
And he gave so many examples like the Euphrates, the river, that it, whatever water it brings today, it brings everything, and tomorrow, it doesn't worry about the water that it's bringing
ولا
tomorrow.
ولا يحول عطاء اليوم دون غد.
He said that the whatever what he's worried about for tomorrow doesn't. He's not worried about tomorrow to keep him from
giving today.
There are no worries about tomorrow that prevent him from giving everything today. So, tawakkul, reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means what? It means to take the means, to strive, to work, to take medicine, etc. To take the means while knowing that the effect...
ما شهودك المدبرة, استحضارك الخالق.
While witnessing and knowing certainly that the one who gives that effect is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That the only thing that occurs is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. That whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wills is what happens, and nothing happens except what He wills.
لا تعتمد على سبب أصلا.
So do not rely upon any means at all.
هذه أجر الله العادة بأنها تأتي المسببات معها وقد لا تأتي معها.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there are things, these are called aada. So it's a habit, it's a normal, it's a thing we expect to see from a cause and effect perspective. But the one who is actually allowing that thing to happen is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
خالق السبب والمسبب.
He's the creator of the cause and the creator of the effect.
السبب ليس حقيقة خالقا للمسبب.
He is the creator of causes. There's no true, really, cause. It's just something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made, that this is what we expect this to do.
وباعتماد القلب في دفع البلاء أصلا ورفعه إذا ما نزل على المصور. ماذا الذي يعينك؟ ماذا الذي يمكنك من التوكل؟ ماذا الذي يمكن؟
So what enables you to have tawakkul? شيخ تعطي أمثلة من هذا السبب وخالق ال
أنا ما سرت أنا كمهل الأدوية وكمهل الأطعمة وكمهل العمل وكمهل النار في حرقها وكمهل الشراب في ريها هذا كله لا فائدة فيه أصلا.
Like medicine and its cure.
إذا تعتقد العلاج بالمديسين هذا كفر.
From experimentation we know that generally somebody who takes this medicine will have this effect. In reality Allah is the one who created the medicine. And he created the effect of it curing. So in reality, the medicine is not creating the effect at all. It's not truly causing anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has paired this effect with the cause of the medicine. So both are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it's Allah who's giving the cure. If you believe for a moment, you're commanded to take the medicine. But if you believe for a moment that the medicine is what causes the cure, then you have disbelieved in Allah.
وإذا تعتقد أن الطعام يشبع أو يروي بنفسه هذا كفر صريح.
Or if you think that the food makes you full on its own, then that's disbelief in Allah.
لأن هذا نسبة الخلق إليها.
This is attributing the creation to the creation of an effect to something that is created.
والله تعالى يقول والله خلقكم وما تعملون.
And Allah says, and Allah created you and that which you do.
الأسباب من ما تعملون.
The effects or and the causes and the means, all of it is from that which you do.
معناها هذه الأمور خطيرة خطيرة جدا.
So these are very critical matters.
هذا هو اللي قلت لكم إن العقيدة مهمة جدا.
That is what I told you. That is what I meant when I told you that learning aqidah is extremely essential.
نعم ماذا لا يعينك على التوكل الاعتماد على الله سبحانه وجل وعلا.
So what helps you rely upon Allah?
وباعتماد القلب في دفع البلاء أصلا على الله.
So the heart should rely to turn away any calamity or any hardship
على الله.
Only upon Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
لا على الأسباب.
Not upon the means.
أصلا قبل أن تأتي.
First of all.
ورفعه إذا ما نزل على المصورين.
So before those problems even come, the one who can hold them back is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if they come, the one who can take them away is Allah. That's it.
وفي إيصال نفع وحفظه من الزوال على المصور. وفي إيصال نفع قبل وجوده تعتمد على الله تعالى. وفي حفظه دوامه على المصور. إيصال أي فائدة.
And then
أي
to
منفع.
Bring about any benefit is only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to preserve any type of blessing, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can preserve المصور. And keep it with you. The creator, the designer.
هذا تصل إلى مقام فطن التوكل. إذا كنت على هذا الحال اعتمدت في القلب على دفع البلاء وعلى رفعه إذا نزل وعلى إيصال النفع قبل الوصول وعلى حفظه من الزوال على المصور تصل مقام التوكل.
So in regard for hardship and difficulty, if your belief is that the hardship can only be protected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if it comes, the only one who can remove it is Allah. And any ease or any blessing is only Allah could bring it and give it to you. And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could preserve it for
تماماً.
You.
تماماً.
If you completely believe this, then you're relying upon Allah.
وصلت إلى التوكل.
That, then you have reached tawakkul.
صرت من يتوكل على الله يعتمد على الله فهو حسبه.
Then you became one of those people that Allah says, and whosoever relies upon Allah, Allah suffices him, Allah takes care of him. Taking means does not mean you're not relying upon Allah. And it's the sunnah that taught to us by the Prophet ﷺ. And he would take medicine every year. And he would put kuhl as medicine every night. And he would use oil as a rub. Teaching us how to take the means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided while relying upon Allah as to be the one who blesses us. Then recite the verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ يَعْتَمِدْ عَلَى اللَّهِ.
And whosoever relies upon Allah, Allah is sufficient for him.
مَنْ يَعْتَمِدْ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى فِي دَفْعِ الْبَلَاءِ.
Whoever relies upon Allah to turn away evil.
وَمَنْ يَعْتَمِدْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فِي رَفْعِ الْبَلَاءِ.
And to take away that evil if it comes.
وَمَنْ يَعْتَمِدْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فِي وَصُولِ النَّفْعِ.
And to rely upon, and those who rely upon Allah to achieve any goodness or any benefit.
وَمَنْ يَعْتَمِدْ عَلَى اللَّهِ عَلَى حِفْظِهِ مِنَ الزَّوَالِ.
And those who rely upon Allah in order to hold on to whatever blessing that He has given. That whatever Allah wills is, and whatever He does not will is not. The means truly do not cause anything, they do not prevent anything. So then, this is the verse that Allah is sufficient for him. Allah is enough for him.
فلها لو اعتمدت على أسباب كلها وكان اعتمادك على الله تعالى هذا عادي لو أخذت الأسباب كلها لكن بالتالي لا تؤمن بشيء فقط كما يقول عمر رضي الله عنه السماء لا تمطر ذهبا وفضة عادة اعملوا إن الله يكره الرجل البطال ولكن بالتالي الرزق سيأتي من الله تعالى.
So then
لو أخذت جميع الأسباب
if you take all of the means
مع اعتمادك
While
على الله تعالى.
you're relying upon Allah, then
وما
you're still
في
in a state
قلبك
of توكل.
اعتقاد أنها ستوصل إليك شيئا.
And not in your heart is any inkling that the reliance
ستزيدك بما كتب الله وتنقصك بما كتب الله.
That those means are what is increasing you anything or decreasing you anything.
ما كتبه الله كان.
Then you'll be like Umar رضي الله عنه, who he said that, you know, Allah did not make the sky a means of raining gold and silver.
قادر أن تكون تمطر ذهبا ما في الضجر.
Yeah, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, if Allah willed, then it would. But Allah did not will that. So then Allah has placed the means in other things. So you have to take those means while relying upon Allah.
إن الله يكره الرجل البطال, يعني فارغ ما يفعل شيء.
That Allah سبحانه وتعالى hates the one who is
الرجل البطال.
The man who is just has no occupation, no is not doing anything, is just free.
ليس عمل رجل.
This is not the actions of a man. Idle.
ثم السلامة من أن تعترض في ظاهر وباطن عين الرضا وهو بابه تعالى الأعظم فاحرص عليه فعساك ترحم يثير فتحه بذكر ما تفضل به عليك من سوابغ ليلا وكن وقورا حالة الزلازل وقل كما عروة قال إبلي ظهور حزن المرء عند المزعج ليس له عن الرضا بمخرج إن سكن القلب كما ابن حجر نسبه في فتحه للطبري اللهم صل على محمد. هذا العلم معدوم غير موجود. كررها علي.
This knowledge is non-existent. It's not anywhere to be seen.
It's
nowhere to be seen. Now the only part of speech that we can use it in is past tense. It was. It was. It used to be.
اسمعوا ثم السلامة من أن تعترض في ظاهر وباطن عين الرضا. هذا هو الخير كما قال عمر رضي الله عنه. خير في الرضا.
That is.
خير في الرضا.
This is as Umar رضي الله عنه said in regard to.
خير في الرضا كما عن عمر.
The goodness is in contentment, in being pleased with whatever Allah chooses.
He said,
so have a contentment with Allah's choice if you can, and if you cannot, if it's difficult, that means be patient. Then go down to the lower level of patience. There's a massive difference between being content in what Allah chose and being patient with what Allah chose.
ثم السلامة من أن تعترض في ظاهر وباطن عين الرضا تسلم لا يقع منك أي اعتراض لا في ظاهر وباطن فيما قدر الله من المكاره.
Contentment, this level of rida, this rank of righteousness of rida above patience, is that you entirely submit. It does not affect you one way or the other. You're completely content whether Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is afflicting you with difficulties, giving you blessings, that whatever is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are smooth sailing. No internal or external objection whatsoever. You go with the flow, accepting peacefully that what Allah chooses for you. يقول
الإمام الشافعي في التسليم وهو الرضا وسلموا إن أراد الله أمرا فأترك ما أريد لما يريد وسلموا أرضى.
That Imam Shafi'i said
وسلموا
that
أرضى.
He said I completely submit when Allah chooses a matter. That because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I give up what I wanted for what Allah chose.
أسلم إن أراد الله أمرا فأترك ما أريد لما يريد. نعرف أن إرادته هي الخير.
I submit whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees any matter and I leave what was my choice for his choice. Because I know he knows me better, what I need better.
What is
and the scholar said in regard to dua, then when you make a dua, you have to know that Allah has guaranteed to answer you, but you do not know what answering your dua means. It's not a command. It's a call to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He has answers your dua in what he chooses, not in what you choose.
يريد,
at
تريد.
The time that he chooses, and not at the time that you choose. Because he knows what's better for you. That this is, as Imam Shafi'i said, that I submit whenever Allah decrees a matter, giving up what I chose for what he chose. That's better. Why would I object to something that Allah chose? Why would I object to a choice by the all-knowing and the all-wise? That he knows that which is good. He knows that which is best for me. And I do not know whatever is gone for me for one moment, and one moment away, I don't know
what's.
And the scholar said that it is from the subtle blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah solves all of the problems that you have by giving you something that's displeasing to you, that's a means to solve all of your problems. It's in the shape of something that is a test or something that you hate. Something that you hate. But in reality, it leads to the solution of your problems and your benefit. And if you
want
to understand this, then read the Quran.
And
likely it is that you would hate something, but it is better for you. And likely it is that you would love something, but it is bad for you. And Allah knows and you do not know.
وما يقول علماء من لطف الله الخفي بيوسف أن أعطاه الملك تحت السجن شيء عجيب.
They say that from the subtle blessing of Allah سبحانه وتعالى that Allah chose for Yusuf عليه السلام to be a king, a leader. But how? Through what means? Through him being in prison.
لو لم يمر على تلك العبودية وعلى السجون وعلى اتهام المرأة أين مصر وأين من العزيز؟
What was his path to become
البيع والشراء.
What is the path for him to attain the rank that he did and be a leader and be the head of agriculture? He was captured into slavery, sold as a slave, and then imprisoned. And then after that, what did that lead to? That he became the treasurer, the head of agriculture.
Was,
now he became like a king.
صار يقول للعزيز مباشرة ماذا الذي تريد يوسف يقوله.
He'd be speaking to the leader
العزيز
himself.
ماذا الذي تريد يا يوسف ماذا الذي تريد.
Yusuf, what do you want? What do you what position in the government would you like?
Oh Yusuf.
Yesterday, this is the same Yusuf alayhi salam who was imprisoned the day before that. And before that, he was accused of zina. And before that, your brothers caused for you to be enslaved. After that, you were bought by the wife of Al-Aziz. Now Al-Aziz tells you, oh Yusuf, what government position do you want? The king of Egypt tells him, what should we do, oh Yusuf? You tell me. That, subhanAllah, this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala changes the affairs like that.
Allah's قال اجعلني على خزائن الأرض.
That he said, make me the head of agriculture.
إني حفيظ عليم خبير.
I'm very capable. I know very well this matter.
وكذلك مكننا ليوسف في الأرض يتبوأ منها.
And that is how we established Yusuf in the land, that he takes from it what he wills.
وجاءت عائلة يوسف من الشام وتلقتها الركبان وصار الأمر يعني يوم عظيم.
And the family, the brothers of Yusuf عليه السلام came from Hashem. And the rest of his family, they came.
وجاءت واستقبلتهم مصر بكاملها.
And Egypt, all of it, welcomed them.
بكاملها استقبلوا خارج البلد.
Welcome them from outside of the city.
من هؤلاء أتون؟
Who are those who are coming being honored
in
this
way? عليه السلام الذي كان عبدا أمس.
This is the family of Yusuf عليه السلام being welcomed in such a manner, and he was a slave yesterday.
هذا هو التدبير الرباني.
This is the divine. لا يحب كلمة plan.
تدبير الرباني.
This is the divine plan manifesting.
ما السلامة من أن تعترض في غير مبطن عين الرضا وهو بابه تعالى الأعظم فاحرص عليه فعساك ترحم وباب الله الأعظم الرضا وباب الله الأعظم خير في الرضا.
So this state of just saying, okay, I don't know, Allah is the one who knows, I'm content. Whatever Allah is my master, I choose whatever He chooses, I'm content with 100%. This is the greatest door to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So be seriously take this door. That you would then be receive Allah's mercy. Be pleased with Allah. Allah would definitely be pleased with
you.
That the reward is based on the action.
روم فتحه وما هو السبب اللي يفتح لك هذا الباب؟ هذا الباب قوي صعب.
So what is the way that Allah opens this door
يفتح لك باب الرضا.
That opens for you the door of الرضا.
روم فتحه بذكر ما تفضل به عليك من ثواب الله. إذا أردت أن ترضى عن الله تعالى انظر إلى ما فتح لك من ثواب إلى النعم الصحة والعافية والتوفيق والمال وكل شيء لماذا لا ترضى عنه في المصائب؟
So then everybody has calamities, everybody has problems. You want to have contentment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then look, focus instead on the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you now, has given you now and has given you in the past. And then how much did he bless you and protect you and provide for you and so on? And be pleased with the challenges are also a blessing.
إذا عددت كل المصائب التي أتتك وقابلتها ما عندك من النعم فهي الصفر.
If you compare the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you with the challenges, the things that the few of those things that he has taken back as a challenge and a test for you, then you'll find that what he has given you is far outweighs whatever he took
away. وإذا أخذت من أول حياتك بالبلايا ووفقت للصبر عليها ووجدت ما لك من الأجر كيف تحصي أيضا هذه نعم أيضا. وإذا ابتليت بالبلايا من يوم مولدك.
Given calamities from day one, from the day that you were born, calamity after calamity and trial after trial, then still.
ورأيت ما يعطيك الله من الأجر عليها والرحمة.
And you were to see the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you and the mercy He gives you as a result of those challenges, then
ما هناك من الأجر.
And you see the reward that Allah is giving you as a result of those things, then you
would
those are blessings as well. You would realize that those challenges that you had are actually blessings of Allah.
معناها رم فتحه بذكر ما تفضل به عليك من ثواب الله ولو لم يكن في البلايا لأنك لا تبتعد عن الله تعالى فهذا كافي من النعم ولو لم يكن
and
في البلايا.
And if you had no blessings except that you were able to be patient during those tests and calamities, that's enough of a blessing.
يوقفك عند الباب.
That should be that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you through those calamities to His door.
That's enough of a blessing that Allah
خير أوقاتك وقت تشهدوا فيه لا شال من إليه يصمدوا.
The best of your times are the times that you witness your need, that you feel your need to the one who takes care of all needs.
لذلك العلماء قالوا وأسبغ عليكم نعمه ظاهرة وباطنة ظاهرة بهذه النعم الظاهرة وباطنة بالبلايا لأنها تقربك إلى الله تعالى وتعطى من الأجر ما تعطى عليه.
This is how the scholars of tafsir interpreted the verse that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that and he has covered you with his blessings internally and externally. The external blessings are like health and wealth and so on. The internal blessings are what people view as calamities and challenges and trials and hardships. That Allah brought you closer through that, rewarded you, purified you, brought you closer to him. Forgave your sins, gave you great reward. Raised your levels. Those are blessings as well. Those are internal blessings. Those are the blessings. They become they actually when you look at it with the right perspective you'll realize that they are also blessings. When you see the reality of it you will know that it's not a calamity. So it doesn't matter what you call something or what you feel about it originally, what does it lead to? And be
وقت الزلازل والمحن والمصائب العظيمة.
And at the time where you are being quaked and struck by the greatest of calamities, be in a state of serenity.
كن وقورا لا سكينة.
Be serene and calm.
يعرف الفرق بين الشجرة والجبل في ذلك الوقت.
The difference between a tree and a mountain is known when the wind blows.
الرياح جبل جبل.
The wind blows, the tornado comes, the mountain's a mountain.
ثابت.
It's standing.
الورقة هكذا.
The tree and the leaves.
كن أنت ثابت.
So be stable.
وقل كما عروة قال من سادات التابعين ابن أخت عائشة رضي الله عروة بن الزبير رضي الله تعالى عنه.
And say what عروة بن الزبير said.
ابن أختي عائشة رضي الله عنها وتربى معها وتعلم منها.
The nephew of عائشة رضي الله عنها who was raised with her and he studied with her.
قال إذ بولي عندما امتحن ابتلاه الله تعالى قل كما قال كن وقورا مثله.
Say what he said once he was afflicted by great trials. Be serene like he was.
هو أحد فقهاء المدينة السبعة.
He is one of the seven فقهاء of Medina that the Maliki madhab is based upon.
ليس المالكي.
That the knowledge was based upon after.
فقهاء المدينة.
That he is one of the fuqaha of al-Madinah for the world.
قبل
the seven of the top scholars of the world after in the time of the tabi'een.
ماذا وقع له?
What happened to him?
امتحن رضي الله تعالى عنه بقرحة في ساقه بلغت به إلى نشر عظم ساقه. إلى قطع عظم ساقه. تلي بقرحة في ساقه.
That he got an infection in his foot. That until his foot had to be cut off.
في الموضع الصحيح منها فقال له الأطباء ألا نسقيك مرقدا.
The doctors told him, should we give you some kind of anesthetic, which was alcohol at the time?
مرقدا شيء ينوم عنك الألم.
An anesthetic.
فلا تحس بما صنع بك.
So that you do not feel what is happening to you.
فلا تحس بما صنع بك. فقال لا.
So he said no.
ولكن شأنكم بها. افعلوا ما تشاء.
He said don't give me anything but do what you have to do.
فنشرت الساق.
So they sawed off his foot.
ثم حسموها بالنار.
And then they
خبت خب.
No, not burned. There's a word. What's the word?
Brand. يفعل السكين وبعد ذلك يضع على مكان.
They cauterized it.
حتى لا ينتشر
that they heat up metal or with heat with fire and then they put it on the wound to cauterize it to stop the blood to burn it.
فما حرك عضوا.
And he did not even move a single limb.
ولا أنكروا منه.
And they did not see any sign on him of.
حتى مسته النار.
And until the fire touched him.
فما زاد على أن قال حسبي.
And then all he said was hasbi, that's enough for me.
وأصيب حينئذ ابنه.
And then his son at that time passed away.
وكان من أحب ولده إليه.
And this was the most beloved son to him.
فلما رأى القدم بيد بعضهم قال أما إن الله يعلم أني لم أمشي بها إلى معصية.
And then once he saw them holding his foot after they cut it off, he said that as for me, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that I did not walk with this foot ever to a sin.
معصية قط.
Ever.
ثم قال بي يا غلام أغسلها وكفنها ودهنها في مقبرة المسلمين.
And then he told the one who cut it off, he said, oh,
يا غلام
man,
slave.
He called his slave, he said, oh, slave, wash it and shroud it and bury it.
في مقبرة المسلمين.
In the cemetery of the Muslims.
وابنه مات.
And his son passed away.
ثم جعل يقول لئن أخذت لقد أبقيت.
And what did he say after all of that?
صنعوا شكر. بدأ الشكر.
He began with what? Gratitude. He said, "Oh Allah, that if you have taken anything back,
لقد أبقيت لي.
You have left for me behind so many other things that I have.
ولئن ابتليت لقد عافيت.
And if you are afflicting me now with calamity, for how long have you protected me from it?
ولئن أخذت لقد طالما أعطيت.
And if you are taking away now, for how long did you give me those things that you took back?
قال تركت خمسة أعضاء.
He said you left five limbs.
وكان لي ستة أبناء فترك خمسة.
And I had six children. You left five.
لئن منعت فقد أعطيت ولئن ابتليت فقد عافيت ولقد طالما أعطيت.
Right. Those are all other children. Those are all blessings from Allah Subhanahu wa Taala that remain. That son himself, how long did he live before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him back?
That foot,
how many other limbs? You took, you gave me six for a long time, now you took one of them back. What's the big deal? And every night he would have recited, he used to recite in the night one quarter of the Quran. But that night, he recited one quarter of the Quran. He didn't change. His state did not change. Gratitude and worship, and that's it. That's his life. He didn't say, Subhanallah, my foot got cut off.
How could this?
And tell everybody, my foot got cut off. What did I do to deserve this? Why
is this
happening? My son died. How could, why is all this happening?
Oh,
I miss my son. Where is my son? He said, oh Allah, you've left behind more than you took. This is the most beloved son of mine, but how many other sons have you left behind? This is my foot that you took back. And how long did I have it for? How long did I have it for before? And how many other limbs did you leave behind for me? So he was in a state of just gratitude at the time of calamity. So this is the rida. This is being content with Allah's choice. That be to the point of having this dignity and serenity and calm even in the state of affliction.
كن وقورا ساعة الزلازل كن وقورا لا سكينة ورضا.
Be calm in the in the time of affliction.
كم هي ما قلت لكم عن مرابط الحاج اليوم.
As I have told you about مرابط الحاج today.
أخذت بنتان من له ماتتا صغيرة.
Two daughters of his.
شابتان جميلتان نظيفتان.
Two young pure daughters of his.
عفيفتان صالحتان.
Righteous.
فما زاد على إن الله
إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون.
اللهم اجرني في مصيبتي وأخلي.
Oh Allah, reward me for my calamity and replace me with better than it. That was his reaction. And he continued his teaching and his state. He did not reduce anything for one day.
ما تغير شيء من حاله.
Did not change his state at all outwardly.
وقال لزوجتي لما حزنت يا مريم ماذا تريدين.
And when his wife, he saw his wife sad, it cheered her up and reminded her.
ماذا تريدين مريم?
He said, Maryam, what do you want?
كانت عليك مسؤولية وفرغاك الله.
You used to have a responsibility, now you're free.
عبودي الله فرغاك للعبادة.
Allah has given you free time for worship now.
هذا بأن تتعلق بالله.
connecting her to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
قال هاي نعمة هو قال هاي نعمة من الله عليه.
In that moment of difficulty, telling her that that calamity was a blessing. هذا بدأ
أنت كنت تعتقدين أنك يعني مبتلات لا أنت كنت مسؤولة عن كم من بنت وكم من مراقبتها الله تعالى أخذها لي ولله ما أخذ وله ما أبقى وأنت الآن جعلك حرة تعبدين الله.
Do you think this is a calamity?
كم من بلية.
This is a blessing. That you had, you were busy taking care of this and doing that for your daughters. And looking after them and worrying about them. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who owns them, and took them back. He took his property back. And he gave you the reward and forgiveness. And he gave you free time for worship. What else do you want? A reward and forgiveness and free time.
ماذا تريدين؟
What else do you want?
تريدين التعنت على الله؟
You want to complain about Allah سبحانه وتعالى؟
هذا له وأخذه.
What is his? He took back.
هو منهج هذا هو المنهج.
This is the methodology.
نشكره إذا أعطانا ونرضى إذا أخذ فقط.
We thank him if he gives us and we are
نرضى.
And we are pleased if he takes what he gave us back.
ما أخذ منا ما لنا لم يأخذ منا ما لنا.
What he is not taking us from us something that isn't his.
ما أخذ منك شيء.
He hasn't taken from you something that's yours.
ومن مال والأهلون إلا ودائع ولا بد يوما أن ترد الودائع.
Your wealth and your family are simply loans.
ولا بد يوما أن ترد الودائع لا بد أن يخلو.
Aren't all loans returned someday?
الودائع لا بد ترجع إلى صاحبها خلاص.
Right, the what you borrowed it needs to be returned.
أودعك وأخذه خلاص.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى allowed you to borrow it. Now he took it back what was his.
لماذا تلوم يعني
What are you blaming? What are you complaining about?
ماذا تريد؟ أخذ وديعته وخلاص. أما المحبة فمعنى قلبه مستوجب لطاعة المحب وأجمعوا على وجوب حبه جل كذا يجب حب حزبه هذه المحبة.
The next rank of righteousness is محبة, love of Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
أما المحبة فرقوا بينها وبين الاتباع.
Differentiate between love and following.
فمعنى قلبي.
Love is found in the heart.
قلبي يستغرق القلب.
It is something that is ingrained and takes over the heart.
يتمكن من نيات القلب.
That is rooted deeply within the heart.
يستلزم طاعة المحبوب.
It leads to obedience of the one who is loved.
فمعنى أهل المحبة هي الأصل. والطاعة فرع عن المحبة.
So what does that mean? It means that love is the root and obedience is the fruit of that those roots.
فإذا كملت أطعت.
If your love is true, that the obedience follows.
وإذا نقصت فقد تبقى ولكن أنت لست كامل المحبة.
And it is a deficient, if it is deficient, then perhaps you will still be able to follow, but you are not complete in your love.
كمثل ما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وضح لنا أن المحبة شيء والاتباع شيء.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم showed us the distinction between love and following.
جاء به إلى رجل حد في حدود كثيرة.
There was a man who was repeatedly punished for doing major sins.
جاء وجاء وجاء وقيم عليه الحد.
And over time and time again he would be brought having been guilty of that sin and punished.
فقال أحد الحاضرين ما أكثر ما يؤتى به.
So someone who was there, he saw this happen. He said, "How many times is this guy going to come?"
فقال دعه إنه يحب الله.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, "Leave him alone. He loves Allah and His Messenger."
عنده محبة لكن ناقص.
That he has love for Allah but is deficient.
لم تتحكم في المحبة إلى أن كملت حتى صار متبعا.
It did not become so ingrained to the point that he became properly following.
لكن بقي له أصل المحبة.
But he had the root of it remaining.
أما المحبة هذا الفرق بين المحبة والمستلزم إذا كملت استلزمت طاعة المحب وإذا نقصت كل ما نقصت المحبة نقص الاتباع.
So whenever you have that love deficient, then the following is also deficient.
وأجمعوا على وجوب حبه جل واجب حب الله تعالى.
And it is obligatory, and there is consensus, of course, that one must love Allah.
ووجوب حب حزبه الأنبياء والعلماء والأولياء.
And it is also required to love the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the prophets and the righteous.
العلماء والأولياء.
The prophets and the أولياء and the scholars.
وإن لم يكن العلماء العاملون أولياء لله فليس لهم ولي.
And of course the top of the أولياء and the top of the أولياء are the practicing scholars. That Imam Shafi'i and Imam Abu Hanifa, they said that if the practicing scholars are not the awliya of Allah, then there are no awliya. Forget about the awliya if the scholars are not awliya.
يقول عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه لو صمت النهار لا أفطره وقمت الليل لا أنامه وأنفقت مالي كله في سبيل الله ولم يكن في قلبي حب لأهل الطاعة وبغض لأهل المعصية ما نفعني من ذلك الشيء.
Abdullah ibn Umar, may Allah be pleased with them both, said that if I spent every night praying and I did not even sleep, and I spent every day fasting and I did not eat, and I gave all of my wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in my heart was not ingrained the love of the people who obey Allah and the hatred for those who disobey Allah, then all of my actions, none of my actions would benefit me at all. That's why they said there is no iman for the one who does not have love in their heart. The sign of iman, the indication of iman, is to love only for Allah and to hate only for Allah.
لا يحب انه افغاني ولا انه عربي ولا انه مكسيكي ولا انه امريكي ولا فقط
لله. Not because somebody is Afghan or Arab or Mexican or American.
لله.
Only for Allah.
ويبغض المرأة لا لأنه من أي شكل لله.
And to hate also not because of anybody's particular attributes but because for the sake of Allah.
عاصي لله. عاصي لله.
Because only this person is disobeying Allah.
فقط.
That's it.
هذه هي المحبة.
That is love.
إفرادك المعبود بالعبادة مع الحضور هو صدق النية ورسم إخلاص عبادة الشكور إفراده بها ولو بلا حضور فهذه مكارم الأخلاق مع الجليل الملك الخلاق. الرجل صار يتخلط من مقامات.
Now you see how he is, subhanAllah.
صار يتخلص من المقامات. صار سيقضي المقامات.
He is concluding the maqamat, the ranks of righteousness.
أعنبها مع الورى رحم وكفو في أذاك واحتمله منهم والطهر. إفرادك المعبود بالعبادة مع الحضور هذا هو الصدق. إفراد المعبود بالعبادة مع الحضور فيها.
The next one is صدق. Which means sincerity. That, oh, you who believe, have taqwa of Allah and be with the sadiqeen, be with the people of sidq, be with the most righteous and sincere.
إفرادك المعبودة بالعبادة مع الحضور فيها.
So what is
sidq?
That only that is specifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. That only doing your actions for the Allah while
ولا لتجد أي شيء لا لصحة ولا الصوم لا لصحة ولا لوقاية إنما هو إفراد المعبود بالعبادة.
While you are present in your action, this is called صدق. Not fasting to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you also have your ulterior motives or for the sake of your health or whatever. No, doing your worship for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. While being present in your worship.
نعم ويبقى الإخلاص دون ذلك.
And sincerity is the level below that.
ورسم إخلاص عبادة الشكور إفراده بها ولو بلا حضور.
And so صدق is to have both sincerity and presence. And sincerity alone, إخلاص, is to just have sincerity.
إفراده بها ولو بلا حضور.
That you're doing it for the sake of Allah only.
ولو بلا حضور.
Even if you're not present.
فهذه مكارم الأخلاق مع الجليل الملك الخلاق. هذه المقامة. هذه مكارم الأخلاق.
He said these are the مكارم الأخلاق.
هذه المقامة.
These are the highest of manners and character that you have with your Lord. These are the ranks of righteousness that you have with the exalted King, the Creator. So then treat the creation with the sincerity. With the good character, with good manners. Have mercy to them. And stay away from harming them. Keep your heart away from them. Bear their burdens. Bear their burdens and handle their evils.
معناها لا تنتصر لنفسك.
Meaning don't get your ego involved. Don't stand up just for the sake of your ego.
اكففوا عن أذاهم.
Have mercy on them. Keep your harm away from them.
احتمل منهم الأذى.
Handle their abuse.
الطف بهم.
And be kind to them.
هذه أخلاق النبوة.
These are the characteristics of prophethood.
سور المقامات إذا يرص بالقلب ليعدو عليه اللص. سور المقامات إذا يلصق بالقلب لا يعدو عليك اللص الشيطان.
That سور. Wall of هذه these المقامات. This fortress of the maqamat that you build بالقلب. Around your heart. لا يلصق بالقلب. That if you place this, bury this fortress around your heart.
إذا يحجز به القلب.
That you secure your heart with it.
لا يعدو عليه اللص شيطان.
The thief cannot overcome that barrier and that obstacle.
شيطان
the Shaitan cannot enter your heart. He's prevented.
لكن هذا السور لا بد منه.
But that fortress, that fortification, that wall needs to be present.
انتهينا من مقامات.
That is the end of the مقامات, the ranks of righteousness.
وما نحتاج أن نصل إلى الله.
But we have to reach to Allah سبحانه وتعالى.
لا بد أن نزيل حجب الوصول.
We have to remove the barrier of attainment.
ما هو حجاب الوصول؟
What is the barrier from attainment?
حضروا أذهانكم.
Pay attention.
من فضلكم حضروا أذهانكم.
Get ready, pay attention.
تعلمون أنكم مستغرقون فيه.
Listen carefully and you'll see that barrier, you're in the midst of that barrier.
ثم تأم أزل حجب الوصول وهي ناس ولص وهوى ودنيا أما الدنا والناس فاربع عنهما همك واجعلوا لفاطر السماء وبدوام الحزن والمراقبة حسب لتنها والنفوس طبب حماية القلب من الشيطان من الفرائض على الأعيان فاتق ما زينه لك الغوي لسير من يضعفت وقوي وسد الأبواب التي منها يصل كشهوة وشباع وكالعجل. الله علمت أن هذا العلم مات علمت.
After hearing this, do you know that this knowledge is and not practiced? Who is practicing it? It's dead.
مات خصوصا عن المنتسبين للتصوف.
This has died away, especially from the people who claim to be Sufis.
هؤلاء ما شموا رائحته أصلا.
They did not smell its fragrance to begin with.
أكسوه أصلا.
They opposed it. They are the opposite of it.
ثم أزل حجب الوصول وهي ناس أولها الناس. حجاب الوصول الناس.
He said, so remove from you the obstacles of attainment of reaching Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Number one, people.
لا تفكر عن الناس.
Don't think about people. Don't be concerned with people.
لا تظن كثرة الأتباع دلت على العلم والاتباع.
Don't think that having many followers indicates knowledge or following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كثرة الأصدقاء لتخليط دليل وقائل الحق صديقه قليل.
Having many friends is a sign of compromise, and the one who tells the truth has few friends.
أما الدنا والناس فارفع عنهما همك.
He said, as for this dunya and as for the people, raise, elevate your concern
لا
above them.
تفكر عنهم لحظة عين.
Don't think about them for one moment.
واجعله لفاطر السماء.
And make your concern, raise your concern above them, and make your concern for the originator of the heavens. Make your concern only be concerned about the creator of the heavens, the originator of the heavens, whether people care, doesn't matter what people say, whether they're pleased with you or not. Treat them kindly and forgive them and have mercy on them.
ولكن إذا وصلنا إلى نقطة التغيير.
But then if it reaches the point of changing for them,
ارفع عنهم همك.
Don't know what will people say. Don't worry about what people will say.
ارفع عنهم الدنيا جاءت الأموال جاءت ولم تأتي ارفع عنها همك.
The dunya also, raise your concern above it. Whether it comes
لا
to you,
تخدعك
it's
غرارة,
to you.
غرارة غرارة غرارة.
It's very very deceptive. Do not be deceived by it.
ارفع عنهم همك واجعله لفاطر السماء.
So raise your concern above this dunya and above the people and make your concern for the creator of the heavens.
واعلم أن في رعي القلوب تعبا أن ترضي بعضا فر بعض غضبا.
And know that if in chasing people's satisfaction and pleasure, you will never be able to please everyone, because if you and you'll exhaust yourself in the process, because if you please some people, some other people run away upset.
فستبقى في الحيرة والعذاب.
That you'll be in a state of confusion and torment.
ومبتغي رضاهم لا ينتظر رضا المصور العزيز المقتدر.
And the one who's waiting for people رضاهم. To be pleased with him, then he will not receive the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
لأن أكثر الناس فاسقون.
Because most people are disobedient, are sinful.
وإن تطع أكثر من في الأرض إيش؟
What does Allah say about following most of the people? If you follow most people, what happens?
الله.
They will misguide you from the path of Allah.
خلاص. تريد رضاهم أو رضا الله.
So you want their pleasure or the pleasure of Allah? That's it.
رضا الله.
Choose Allah.
رضا الله غاية مدركة. انتزل أوامره واجتنب نواهيه.
To please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that is possible.
ممكن. امتثل الأوامر واجتنب النواهي.
To obey his commands and to stay away from his prohibitions.
رضا الناس غاية لا تدرك.
Trying to please everyone, that's something that no one can.
خواطر تتغير وقلوب تتغير ووجهات تمشي وتأتي.
People's minds change. People's whims and desires fluctuate.
تتبع أشياء تتغير في الثانويات. أشياء تريد أن تحصل على.
You're trying to chase after something that that person he might like something else the next day.
أما الدنا والناس فارفع عنهم همك واجعله لي فاطر السماء. الأعداء أسباب الحجب الوصول أربعة الناس والدنيا.
So the four barriers to attainment from attainment are the four enemies, the people and the dunya.
ناس ونص وهوى ودنيا.
The nafs and the hawa remain, the self and the desires.
بقية ماذا بقية؟ اللصوة والشيطان والهوى.
The shaitans, forgive me, the shaitan and the desires.
هذا مثال. وبدوام الحزن والمراقبة حسب لاتنها والنفوس طبيبة إدارة تطببها والناس الحزن.
He said, what is the
تحزن cure? على ما أنت فيه من الفساد.
What is the cure for
الهوى.
The lustful desires of the self,
حزن
the
على
whims
حالك.
And desires
حزن على حالك.
Is sadness.
والمراقبة لهواك.
Sadness over your state and monitoring your desires critical.
والحسبنا حسبنا الله والوكيل حسبنا الله.
Also saying حسبنا الله or حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل.
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل.
هذا الهوى.
This is the treatment for the whims and desires.
الحجاب الرابع الشيطان.
The fourth obstacle, the fourth barrier. Is the shaitan.
حماية القلب من الشيطان من الفرائض على الأعيان.
Protecting your heart from the shaitan is one of the requirements that every individual must do.
ما هي الحماية؟
How do you protect yourself from the shaitan?
فاتقي ما زينه لك الغوي. كل ما زين لك قل خلاص انت لم تزين لمصلحة.
Stay away from everything that he makes sound appealing to you. Whatever he adorns for you, say no thanks. That's where this is where we part ways. I know that my enemy does not adorn for me anything that's actually good. Especially if you are weak and he has that strength, that power over you, using that against yourself. As is our state right now, we're so vulnerable to the attacks of the shaitan. The shaitans of the humankind and jinn, whenever they invite you, say no thanks. No, not even thanks.
عائلة شياطين الإنس.
That your family, subhanAllah, usually consists of the devils of humankind. That you want to lead me to evil, I know that you're not good for me. That I know that there is no goodness in my relatives. 100%.
لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال الولد مجبنة ومبخلة.
Just like the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that having children leads to cowardice and stinginess.
معنى سبب البخل وجبن حب كره الموت.
Meaning it's a cause of being stingy and of being cowardly.
قال لي رب العالمين إن من أزواجكم وأولادكم عدو لكم.
And Allah سبحانه وتعالى says that indeed from your wives and from your spouses and your children are an enemy to you. So I have to monitor this possible enemy.
والله قال إن جاءكم فاسق يا جاءكم عدو ماذا يكون؟ So جاءكم فاسق بنبأ فتبينوا.
Allah سبحانه وتعالى tells you what to do if you have an enemy, that if they come to
فاسق
you with
ما هو عدو
or just a sinful person.
وليس عدو.
And they're not your enemy. You make sure before you accept anything from them.
فما بالك بالعدو.
So what about an enemy?
عليكم عدو اقبلوا. السلام عليكم ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير.
Your enemy comes to you, you should accept it then.
عدو.
If a person who is sinful, then be suspicious. But if someone's your enemy.
إن جاءكم فاسق فتبينوا لكن إن جاءكم عدو فاقبلوا.
So you think, so why are you accepting then what your enemies are telling you?
جاءكم فاسق زوجة وأولاد قال لك فعلا لا تتصدق ونحن سنموت والمشاكل وخلي عنك التعلم وأنت ضعته لك قولهم السلام عليكم قال لي رب العالمين أنكم أعداء.
What are wife and kids and family saying? Oh, you know, don't give in charity. You know, you're going to make us poor. How are we going to have our needs met? Leave something for us. You know, don't go and learn. What are you doing spending all that time learning? Every day you're involving yourself in learning. What is this?
نحن سنموت.
We're going to die. You're going to kill us. Okay, die.
موتوا أماتكم الله.
Die, may Allah cause you to die. Your death is in terms of, as far as I'm concerned, that's a break for me. I don't need enemies. This is a break for me.
راحة إذا كان المشاكل فقط تركتنا وفعلت هذا عذاب هذا إذا كانت الزوجة
Oh you abandoned us where did you go all that time
أبي موتكم راحة لي
If it's just nothing but problems and an obstacle from goodness then that obstacle going away is a break that enemy leaving
أنتم أعداء هاي راحة لي حقيقة هاي نرجو الله أن يميتكم لأن يحتاج الراحة
Right
أرجو الله أن يميتكم عني لأن أحتاج.
In that case, I would wish for Allah سبحانه وتعالى to take you away because.
أنا أرتاح لأن هذا عذاب.
Because then I would get a break.
كل ما أريد علم، كل ما أريد صلاح نفس أنتم تتعرضون لي. ماذا أريد؟
Whenever I want to improve myself, whenever I want to learn, you oppose me.
ما أي عداوة فوق هذا؟
What opposition is there and what enemy is there greater than that?
أنا لا أريد منكم شيئا.
No, thank you. I don't want anything.
أمر الفرق بينكم وبين زوجتي إبراهيم عليه السلام.
Look at the difference between that kind of wife and the wife of Ibrahim عليه السلام.
تركها مع إسماعيل عليه السلام في أرض مكة يعني أرض فلات لا ماء فيها ولا شيء صيف.
That he left her in Mecca in the summer.
أرض تشوي الوجوه تشوي اللحم.
In a land that was so hot that people are being cooked.
ولا ماء ولا
And there was no water to be found around there. He left his wife and his newborn son.
Ismail alayhi salam.
That there was no greenery, there was no foliage, no fruit, no trees, no plants. Rocks and sand. And he told them, Assalamu alaikum, I'm leaving. Where are you going? She called after him, where are you going? He said, I'm going. He did not answer. I don't know when I'm coming back. All she said was, did Allah command you to go? Did Allah command you this?
قال نعم.
He said yes.
قالت إذا لا يضيعنا الله.
She said then Allah will not let us lose.
إن كان أمر من الله تعالى.
If this is a command from Allah, Allah will take care of us. That's it. Go ahead.
لكن أنتم عندكم أمر من الله. هذا عالم يريد الدعوة. هذا شخص يريد أن يطلب العلم. أمر من الله تعالى. لا ضيعتنا ومشاكل وكل المشاكل وأنت لا تبالي بأهلك. وابنك ما عندك له رحمة وأنت مشتغل بالعلم وما عندك رحمة وما عندك فتنة.
But if you're busying yourself with knowledge, oh no, why aren't you, you know, doing this and that, and why are you gone all this time, and why are
ما
you?
ما عندك رحمة لأولادك.
You don't care about your children. You
ما
have
عندك
no mercy.
حب لزوجتك.
And you don't love your wife.
ما أنت تبغض زوجتك.
You hate your wife.
هذه المرأة ماذا قالت لزوجها نبي من أنبياء الله.
This woman, what did she say to her husband, who is a prophet of Allah?
من أكرم الأنبياء.
And from the greatest of the prophets.
قالت الله أمرك بهذا.
She said, "Did Allah command you this?"
قالت إذا لا يضيعنا الله.
Yes, then Allah will take care of us.
لماذا ما تقول
أنت؟ We cannot lose. Allah will not let us.
لماذا لا تقول أنت مالي؟
So why don't you say that instead?
أمرنا الله بالتعلم.
Allah has commanded us to learn.
ونهانا عن الجهل.
And He forbade us to stay ignorant.
وأعظم معصية ترك التعلم.
And the greatest sin is abandonment of knowledge.
أنت عدو خلاص.
So then if you want to stop me from that, you're my enemy. You're not a wife, you're a problem.
لماذا تقولون happy wife, happy life? لماذا تقولون الكذب?
Why do you keep repeating the statement happy wife, happy life?
هي لن ترضى عنك إلا إذا كنت حمارا.
Why are you repeating this lie? She will not be happy with you unless you become her donkey.
هذه happy life, هذا راحة.
Is that a happy life?
هذه حمار life.
That's a donkey life.
هذه حياة الحمار مأخوذة منه وتجعل عليه القرار ترجم
نعم
مأخوذة منه وتجعل عليه القرار
she grabs him by the ears and loads him up
تجعل عليه المتاع
and she puts her
burden هذه هي شغلة الحمار هذا هو عمل الحمار
that is the job of what? That's a
donkey إلينا في موريتانيا
Go to Mauritania and watch. You'll see. They grab the donkey by the ears and they put the water containers on
Go.
His back.
اذهب. اذهب. العصا وراك. العصا وراك.
Go. The stick is coming after you.
تعطل قليلا تضرب. تعطل قليلا. مشي.
If you hold back, take a break for a second, you'll be beaten.
هذا هو حال الزوج.
This is how husbands are here.
هل هذا حق أم لا؟
Is this the truth or not? This is absolutely the truth.
أنت رجل تعرف أنك أمريكي.
You're a man. You're from here. You're from American.
هذه عداوة.
This is not a relationship.
هذه مصيبة.
This is not a wife. This is a problem.
Happy wife, happy life. That's stupid.
What do you mean, happy wife, happy life?
I hate this speech. لماذا ما تقول please Allah تعالى happy life?
Why don't you say if you please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala means a happy life and in this world and the hereafter.
Yeah.
Pleasing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the success of both worlds. Why don't you speak from a position of reality? To say that the pleasure of a creature A creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is
ثم لا تعبدون الله انتم تعبدون الزوجات
You're not worshiping Allah then you're worshiping your husbands and your wives you're worshiping your wives
فاتق ما زينه لك الغوي لسيما ضعفت وقوي وسد الابواب التي منها يصل سد الابواب التي ياتي منها الشيطان سدها اغلقها
اغلق الابواب close the barriers that the shaytan takes advantage of
كشهوتي
Such as your desires.
وشبعي.
And being full all the time.
وكالعجل.
And being hasty.
هذه مصيبة.
Always being in a rush. These are all calamities.
ورابط النفس بست اللولى إلزامها أن تجور المحول منعا وكرها أبدا وتاتي صديقة بنوعي الطاعة ثم تراقبنها في الخيم إذا خل الجو له لا يقر ثم تحاسبها وتكليب الجواب عما أتت وتركت والحساب إن أتمت فاشكري المهيمنة وأوصيها بجعل لك ديدنا واطلب قضاء ما تركت وجبر ما ناتت وإن عصت فعاتب لائمة ثم تعاقبن كل جريحة بمنع ما تقحمته طالحة كالبطن من جوع إذا ما كلا محرما وغض طرف أرسلا وجاهدنها بإلزام النوافل للكثيرة وهجران الهوى جهادها الحمل على المكاره شرعت والكف عما تشتهي والشرط في جهادها السني وفقه لسنة النبي من ظن أن يصل دون جهدي فمتأني أو ببذل الجهد أمام من ظن أن يصل دون جهدي فمتمني أو ببذل الجهد فمتأني أو شهي الأكل ليس يضره أتى بإذن. هنا نتوقف حتى نصلي المغرب ونختم الدروس بعد المغرب ونرجو الله حسن الختام.
Inshallah, we'll take a break over here and until we pray, so we can pray Maghrib, and then we'll begin immediately after Maghrib to complete the book.